Hi and hello to everyone. In this video, we are going to work out few problems based on K-map simplification, right? The question should be like simplifying sum of product or product of sum expression. Okay, welcome to the lecture. The question is find the minimal sum of product and minimal product of sum for the given question, right? And we very well know that the symbol pi, this stands for product. The symbol summation, this stands for sum. As well as we should be knowing that M stands for capital M. Capital M stands for max term. Max term is nothing but the sum. You can say or operation or sum operation. Small m stands for min term. Min term is nothing but AND operation, nothing but product. Okay, that is why we say, if you look at this, pi stands for product, M stands for OR operation. Okay, so I can say this as the given question is in the form of product of sum. Or what is sum? Sum is nothing but max term. Or else I can say this as product of max term. Okay, product of sum, POS, right? That is the question. Okay, the given expression is given, the complete relation is given. They are asking for the minimal. We want to reduce that using K-map, right? So they are asking what is the minimal product of sum. They are asking what is the minimal product of sum, which is the POS. As well as they are asking what is the minimal sum of product, which is your SOP. Okay, right. So we should be very clear that one more thing you want to recollect here is the max term is always zero. Max term is always zero. Min term is always one. Always one. So I am going to represent max term. Each of the term is a max term. Max term is represented by zero. The terms which are not present in this are nothing but the min term. Okay, capital M indicates the max term. Capital M indicates, see, look at the capital M. Capital letter M indicates the max term. Okay, what are the terms missing here? Number 0 is missing, 2 is missing, 5, 6, 8, 9, 11, 12. These are the terms missing. They are nothing but the min terms. The terms which are present is called the max term. Okay. Right. Now for this, I can convert this expression. Okay, I can convert this expression, which is the product of sum, into sum of product. What is sum of product? The terms which are absent in this, right? That is a function, Boolean function E is a function of W, X, Y, Z, four variable, can be sum of products or summation symbol, small m. Small m indicates min term. You can see it here. Small m indicates min term, which is nothing but the product term. Okay, what are the terms missing in the question? You can see it here. As I explained, it is 0 is not there, 2 is not there, then 0, 2, 3, 4 is there, 5 is not there, 6 is not there, 8, 9, 10 is there, 11, then we don't have 12, we don't have 12, we have 13, 14, 15. Okay. Right. Since we have four variables W, X, Y, Z, we have the numbers from 0 to 15. Okay. 0 to 15 is the range for four variables, right? So what are the missing terms inside 0 to 15 is? These are the terms which are not present in this. Okay, right. So here we can clearly see what does this indicates. This indicates sum. M indicates min term, which is the product term, right? So this is your sum of products. That is your SOP. Okay, or else this can be also set as sum of minterm. Minterm. And remember, minterm is always 1. Max term is always 0. This point you have to remember. Okay, now we move into K-map and we try to simplify. Okay, so we are going to construct the K-map. So remember, what are the numbers are given for the max term? They are given 1, 3, 4, 7, 10, 13, 14, 15. So we have to mark the position as 1, 3, 4, 7, these numbers as 0, and these numbers 0, 2, 5, these numbers as 1. Because they are the min term. Min term is always 1. Max term position we are going to always work with 0. Okay, so we are going to construct the K map. So it is a, we have 4 variables, so we go for 16 box K map. Right, okay, first we will go for sum of product, right? We are going to reduce the sum of product, SOP, right? What are the variables? Variables are WX, we are taking in the rows, and YZ, we are taking in the columns. This is your 00, 01, 11, 10. This is your 00, 01, 11, 10. We can see there is a single bit change, 0, 0, here the 0 is converted to 1. Similarly, 0, 1, this 0 is converted to 1. Single bit change between the one column and the next column. Similarly, single bit change while you go from one row to the next row. Okay, similarly, the first row and the last row, you see 0, 0 is there, 1, 0 is there. So they are also having a single first row and last row. If you compare, there is a single bit change. And the first column and the last column, if you compare, 0, 0, 1, 0, a single bit change, right? So this is nothing but 0, 0 means I can write it as W bar X bar, W bar 0, 1 means WX, 1, 1 means WX, 1, 0 means WX bar. Okay, in the same way, I can write here as Y bar, Z bar, here Y bar, Z, Y, Z, Y, Z bar. Okay, right, I have written in the terms of min terms, right? So we very well know. What is the corresponding decimal number? See here, 0, 0, 0 corresponds to this digit is 0 here, right? Then 0, 0, 0, 1 corresponds to 1. Similarly, double 0, W, X, Y, Z, it is in this order. 0, 0, 1, 1, which corresponds to 3. 0, 0, 1, 0, which corresponds to 2. Okay, the binary number I am writing in the decimal form inside the boxes. Okay, right. So 0, 1, double 0. 0, 1, double 0 corresponds to 4, 0, 1, 0, 1 corresponds to 5, 0, 1, 1, 1, okay, so it corresponds to 7, 0, 1, 1, 0 corresponds to 6, okay, then 1, double 1, double 0 corresponds to, it's 12, it is, this is 13, this corresponds to 15, you can extend this, this corresponds to 14, here, 100 corresponds to 8, this is 9, okay, this is 11, this is 10, right? Now we are going to fill the min terms. What are the min terms? Min terms are present in the position of 0, 2, 5, 6, 8, 9 and 11 and 12, okay? So fill it there. It's 0, it is 1, min term is always 1, at 2 it is 1, at 5 it is 1, at 6 it is 1, at 8 it is 1, at 9 it is 1, then 11 it is 1, then 12 it is 1. Okay, we have marked the values. The rest of the terms are zeros. Okay, rest of the terms are zeros. Right, you can clearly see where and all 0 here, at 1, 3, 4, 7, then 10, 4, 13, 14, 15, which corresponds to the given question, the product of max terms. Okay, first we are going to simplify sum of product, because in the question they are asking both, right? They are asking sum of product and product of sum, so we are doing sum of product. Okay, so we are going to group in sum of product, we are going to group the ones, that is group the min terms, right? In sum of product, we group the min terms. So look how I am grouping, right? So this one is only separate. I can group this one. There is no adjacent ones, right? Similarly, I can group these two ones. Okay, I can group these two ones, these two ones. Then I can group these two ones. Similarly, since the first column and last column are adjacent, I can group this way also. I'll use some other color for the convenience. Yes. Right. So I have done how many groupings? This is one group, second, third, fourth, fifth. So five groups I have. Each of the group will give a simplified min term. Okay. Let me start with the green one. Okay. What is this corresponds to? This green grouping, it corresponds to, if you look at in the left side, we have 0, 0 as common, which corresponds to W bar, X bar. In the column, what is common? We have 0, 0, we have 1, 0. So 0 is common, 0 corresponds to Z bar. So this grouping corresponds to, I can write it as W bar, X bar, Z bar. Okay, now we group this group. Okay, right. Look at this. What is common in the left side? 0, 0 is common, which corresponds to 0, 0 is common, which corresponds to W bar. W bar is common. And in the top, what is common? Y and Z bar. So this corresponds to W bar, Y and Z bar. Okay. Similarly, here what is common for this in the left hand side? Here this common is W, X bar. In the top, what is common for this group? 1, 1 is common, which corresponds to Z. Here, what is common here for this grouping? In the left hand side, 1, 1 is common, which corresponds to W. In the top, what is common? 0, 0 is common, which corresponds to Y bar, Z bar. Okay. Similarly, for the center one, this one, what is common? Here in the side, that is which is common, W bar X is common, the top Y bar Z is common. So it is W bar X Y bar Z. So we have obtained the min term for each of the grouping. So the simplified answer is, so minimal sum of product. Okay, remember each of the term is a product term. Okay, each one is a min term, they are combined and it gets simplified, right? So minimal sum of product for the given question is expression E, X comma W X Y Z is equal to, just you add all the product terms, that's all, that is the answer. And remember, K-map is not unique. There are so many ways, but this answer, this is the best way you can group. Okay. There are some cases where you can have multiple options also. And always remember, it should have minimum number of literals. Here we have 3 literals, here also 3 literals. That should be ensured. Okay, just I am summing up all the min terms or simplified product terms. Okay, so this is the answer. This is the minimized, there is a minimal sum of product or sum of min terms. Now we go into the second one. We are going to simplify the product of sum. Okay, in product of sum, what I'm going to do is, 1 minute, yes. In product of sum, I'm going to group these zeros, right? Group here, in product of sum, grouping of zeros is done. Here in the sum of product, we have grouped ones. That is, we grouped the min terms. Here we are grouping max terms. Okay, right. So we'll use the same table, right? Same table. because this table we have grouped zeros. Now we are going to group the, previously we grouped the ones, here we are going to group the zeros, right? Okay, I am redrawing, right? Again, here very important thing, we are going to write everything in the form of plus. Here it is w, x, here it is y, z. That's fine. So this is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. This is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. Note here, since we are going to group the product of sum, each term is a sum term. So 0, 0 is written as w plus x. Okay, 0, 1 is written as w plus x bar. This is w bar plus x bar. This is w bar plus x. Okay, similarly here it is y bar, it is y plus z. This is y plus z. See, wherever 0 as it is, wherever it is 1, we are going to complement. So it is y plus z bar. This is y bar plus z bar. This is 1 is there. So y bar plus 0 means same thing, z. Okay, now you just again the same way we have to repeat. This is 0, 1, the weightage 3, 2, this is 4, this is 5, 7, 6, 12, 13, 15, 14, 8, 9, 11, and 10. What are the terms? Where and all we have zeros, just to plug it as we've done in the previous one. We have 1 here, then we have 1 here, then we have 1 here. Then we have 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Rest all is 0. Okay, rest all is 0. So this is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Each 0 corresponds to max term, right? So grouping of max term means we have to group the zeros, right? So look, where are the zeros are there? We have 2 zeros. I am grouping it in this way. Okay, always go for bigger groups. Remember, while grouping, we have to group single box, two box, four box, eight box. You cannot group three box, five box. Okay, you can group like this, and here you can group it like this. Okay, this we can group it like this, and I can group it like this. Then I can group it like this. Right, this is how the grouping is done. Now the same way, find out the max term for each of the groups. Okay, for this, okay, what is common in the left side? W plus x. What is common in the top? Z bar is common. So it is w plus x plus z bar. Okay, for this red color grouping, what is common in the left side? X bar is common. What is common in the top? Y bar plus z bar. So it is x bar, y bar plus z bar. Okay, right. What is common here for this? What is common in the left side? 1, 1 is common, which corresponds to w bar, x bar, w bar. What is common in the top for this? Top is y bar plus z. Important, right? Wherever it is 1, we are complementing. 0 means as it is. It is opposite to what we did in min term. There we made a product. Here we are making plus. And you see here, y plus z bar, it is converted to y bar plus z, right? Okay, that's why I am solving both the problems, both the sum of minimal sum of product and product of sum in a single question itself. Thereby you will get clarified. So it is w bar. What is common in the top? 1, 0 is common, which corresponds to y bar plus z. Okay, similarly, I can group it, group for this grouping, right? What is common in the left side? W bar, x bar. What is common in the top? Z bar. Right here, what is common in the left side? W, x bar. What is common? W plus x bar. What is common in the top? 0, 0, which corresponds to y plus z. Okay, now you make an AND operation or product of each of the sum term. Okay, So I can conclude the question as minimal product of sum. Sum is nothing but max term, product of max term. Okay, that is POS. Is nothing but a Boolean expression which is a function of W, X, Y, Z. We got the product term, each term, what is it? We got a sum term. What is the first term? First term is W plus X plus Z bar multiplied with AND operation. Multiplication means AND operation with the second term, X bar plus Y bar plus Z bar. Okay, what is the third term? Third term is W bar, Y bar plus Z. The fourth term is W bar, X bar plus Z bar. The last term is W plus X bar plus Y plus Z. Okay, so this is your minimal product of sum, right? So you have done sum of product and product of sum, right? Quickly we'll refresh. See, what are the terms? Look at the symbol. This indicates product, right? Product, and capital M indicates sum operation, though it is a product of sum. Okay, sum term is nothing but max term, adding, we are doing OR operation. So you have to group zeros to find out POS. Okay, what are the terms which are not absent here? Indicates the min terms. Min term is always 1. We started with the sum of product, that is SOP. We are grouping the ones. Similarly, we did POS. We are grouped zeros. Okay, this is the first problem. Right, now one more problem we shall do. Yes, here we are the same thing. The question is find minimal POS and SOP. That is the question, right? Okay, so what is given in the question? In the question, they have clearly given in the form of sum of products. And this DC indicates don't care. Don't care means it can be either 0 or 1. Depending on the grouping, we can use it for our advantage. Okay, right. So first there are some of, so what you have to do? We have to do for even the product of sum. Okay, so how will you convert to product of sum? That is, in product of sum format, the Boolean expression E as a function of W, X, Y, Z. For product, we are using pi. Okay, for sum term, that is a max term, we are using capital M. What are the terms missing here? You can clearly see 0, 4, 5, 9, 11, 14, 15, 2 and 8 are don't cares, right? So we have to see 1 is not there. Okay, 0, 1 is not there, 2 is here, right? 2 is there in the don't care, right? 2 is there, not there, is there in the don't care, right? So we don't have 3. Okay, we have 4 and 5. We don't have 6, we don't have 7. 8 is there in the don't care. Okay, 8 is there in the don't care. We have 9, we don't have 10. We have 11, we have two, don't have 12, we don't have 13, 14, 15. Okay, so this is your product of sum expression. Okay, now we go for the K-map, right? Okay, once you go for the K-map, first thing, we are going to simplify for SOP. We have to go for 16 box K-map. Right? So this is your WX, this is your YZ, so 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, this corresponds to W bar X bar, this corresponds to 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, this corresponds to Y bar Z bar, okay. So you can fill the values like this is 0, 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5, this is 7, this is 6, this is 8, this is 9, this is 10, this box is 10, this is 11, this is 12, this is 13, this box is 14, this is 15. Okay, now since we are going for sum of product term is nothing but the min terms. Okay, sum of min terms, right? Where we have 0, 4, 5, 9, we have to fit it as 1. Okay, 0 is fit as, we are, for 0 we are putting 1, at 4 we are putting 1, at 5 we are putting 1, at 9 we are putting 1, at 11, at 14, at 15 we are all putting 1, right? And 2 and 8 is don't care, we are going to put like D. Okay, at 2 we are putting D, at 8 we are putting D. Okay, other terms are nothing but the max terms. You are going to put like 1, 3, 6, 7. See, 1, 3, 6, 7, 12 and 13. 12, 13, yeah, 10, 12. This is your 10, 10, 12, 13. We are going to put zeros. Okay. Again, I repeat, the zeros are the max term or sum term. One are the min term or the product term. D stands for don't care. Since we are working with sum of product, we have to group ones and don't cares. That is your ones and D's we have to group, right? And I missed out 6. Yes, 6 is also, what is 6? 6 is present in the max term. Okay, so I have to make it like 6, I am putting 0. Right, now I am going to simplify. Okay, see here, I am going to group the ones and don't care because I am interested in sum of product. How I have to group? I am taking some other color. Yes, I am grouping these ones. These two ones can be grouped. Okay, then these two ones can be grouped. Right. Then don't care is up to our benefit, right? Okay, see here, these two ones can be grouped. Similarly, these two ones are grouped. You have grouped all ones without the help of any don't care. Okay, see, people may feel that why I should not group box 8 and 9. Right, I can group this, but it is of no use. Already this one is covered in this group. So we have not, don't care is for our benefit. Okay, if it is helped in reduction, we can use it. Here, don't care help is not required. So we didn't touch at all. We didn't use at all. Okay, so we are going to write for each of the grouping. We are going to start from here. For this group, what is common in the left hand side? W bar is common. What is common in the top? Y bar, Z bar. So it is W bar, Y bar, Z bar. Okay, for this group, what is common in the left side? W bar X. What is common in the top? The top Y bar is common. Okay, here what is common for this group? W X is common. What is common in the top? Y is common. Right? Y is common. For this group, in the last row, what is common? Common in the left hand side, W, X bar. If it is one row or one column, as it is, we can write the full terms. If it is two rows and two column, we have to look for the common terms. Simple, right? So what is common in the top? It is covering the two columns, right? So Z is common here. So it is Z. Okay. So, the minimal, what is the final answer? The minimal SOP. Minimal sum of product, where the Boolean expression is a function of W, X, Y and Z is equal to, we have to add all the min terms. Each of the term is a min term, which is a product term. That is W bar, Y bar, Z bar, W bar, X, Y bar, plus W, X, Y, plus W, X bar, Z. Right? Okay, we have done for the sum of product. Next, we shall proceed for the product of sum. product of sum, what you have to do? We have to group the zeros and don't cares, right? Okay. Next, we are going to group the product of sum. That is, we are going to group 0 and t, right? So we are going to go for the same table. Only thing, we are going to write in the terms of max terms. That is product of sum. Sum term is also called max term. So this is your wx, this is your yz. So 0 0 0 1 1 1 1 0. Alternating one in an adjacent box will differ with only one bit. That is the reason we are writing in this fact, this way. Okay, so we can say 0 0, this corresponds to double 0 means as it is, we can write w plus x. Here 0 plus 1, w plus x bar. This is w bar plus x bar. This is w bar. 1 means bar we have to put, 0 means as it is. Okay, here it is 0 0, so it is y plus z. Here it is 0 y plus z bar. Both are 1, so y bar plus z bar. Here y is 1, so y bar plus z. Remember, max term is always 0. Okay, now fill as usual. This is 0, 1, 3, 2. This is your 4, 5, 7, 6, 8, 9, 11. This is your 10, 12, 13, 15. This is your 14, right? As usual, you fill the same table we are going to fill, but only thing, for product of sum, we are going to group the zeros and don't care. Zeros and don't care, right? You see here, now we are going to help get the help from the don't care. You see here, we have two zeros. We can group it like this, we can group it like this, we can group these two. Okay, I will repeat. We can group this way, we can group this way, we can group this way. But instead of doing three groupings, so what I can do is, I can go for, by including this, considering this don't care as zero. See, because don't care can be zero or one. For our benefit, for our advantage, I am going to consider this d as zero. Thereby, I can make this four box as a single box. Okay, so remember what I'm going to do now is, I'm not going to do in this way. I'm grouping these two. Now I'm going to group it like this. Okay, now I'm next time grouping this, right? And remember, this zero can be either grouped with this don't care, because the first column and last column are adjacent, or this zero can be grouped with this don't care. Both are same. That's why I said K map is not unique. Right? Suppose you are doing it like this. Okay. Let me say you are doing it like this. Your friend may group like this. He will group this zero and this don't care. Both are correct. Right? Okay. So we will do like this. Now we write the max term for each of the grouping. So we write for this group, right? What is common in the left side is your w plus x. Okay, we are going to write in some form, plus form, or gate. So in the top, the common is z bar. Okay, for this, what is common here? W is common. What is common in the top? Y bar. Okay, for this, the common is W bar plus X bar. What is common in the top is Y. Okay, here, what is common? You have to consider both, because this is the same box. Okay, two boxes I have grouped. The common in the left side is, since it is single row, we have to write all the term, that is W bar plus X. In the top, consider both the column, which is common 0, 0, which corresponds to Z. Okay, right. So finally, we got the minimal minimal product of sum. Okay, that is POS. Okay, we can also say sum is nothing but product of max term. You can say instead of sum, you can use the term max term, right? So the Boolean expression E, which is a function of W, X, Y and Z, is equal to W plus X plus Z bar, W plus Y bar, W plus X bar plus Y, W bar plus X plus Z. So this is the minimal product of sum expression. Okay, right. And even I can give one more example, right, which is for give a solution, right? This is the question, right? Here it's and the number is going up to 0 to 6. It's a three variable means 8 box is sufficient, right? So it is 0 1 4 6. What are the missing terms? So convert this into product of sum form. The given, this is in sum of product or sum of min terms. A small m indicates min terms, this symbol indicates sum. Okay, so it is like what are the terms missing? Product of sum, capital M for max term. What is missing? 2 is missing, 3 is missing, 5 is missing, 7 is missing. Okay, these are the terms missing, right? So you can form a k-map. First we start with the SOP, quickly I will do, right? So 3 variable means how many boxes? 8 boxes only, right? Here I am taking X, here I am taking Y, Z. This is 0, 1, so this corresponds to X bar, this is X, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. This is Y bar, Z bar, Y bar, Z, Y, Z, Y, Z bar, right? So this is 0, 0, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, triple 1 is 7, this is 6. Okay, what are the terms present? At 0 it is 1, at it is 1, this is 4, this is 6. Okay, rest of the term, that is 2, 3, 5, 7, I can put 0. Group it, we can group it. No, instead of this, we can group this way also. Yes, this is the best answer, right? So what is common here? Common in the left hand side is X bar, the top, the common is Y bar. For this grouping, that is for both, okay, consider this both as a single group, what is common in the left hand side is X, what is common in the top is Z bar. So the simplified, that is a minimal SOP is X bar, Y bar plus X, Z bar. Right, now we can move into how to simplify the product of sum. In product of sum, the same thing I'm going to write, but only the difference is X, Y, Z, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0. Here I'm going to write it as 0 means X, 1 means X bar. Okay, this is Y plus Z. This is Y plus Z bar. Here it is Y bar plus Z bar. Here it is Y bar plus Z. Okay, so as usual, we fill the values 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. Right? Now, for the product of sum term, we have to group the zeros, right? So what is common here? So the common in the left hand side is X, in the top it common is Y bar. Here the common in the left hand side is X bar, the top the common is Z bar. So the minimal POS is product of these two groupings. Okay, right. I hope you learned something useful from the lecture. Thanks for listening. See you.